This is an excerpt of a recent power-up webinar on the new features in Adobe Premiere Pro version 14.4. Hi, this is Larry Jordan. In this excerpt, I want to illustrate why correctly setting the HDR graphics white point is important when adding graphics or SDR media to an HDR sequence. Premiere now supports Rec 2100 HLG, that's hybrid log gamma, HLG media shot using either Apple ProRes or Sony XAVC Intra video formats. Other codecs are not yet supported. HDR remains a work in progress for Premiere. Adobe tells me that while HLG is supported now, version PQ is coming soon. Also, support for other formats is coming soon. So this is absolutely an evolving set of features in Premiere, but it works well for the video codecs that it supports. Apple ProRes and Sony XAVC Intra are fully color managed and GPU accelerated, and VideoScope's now automatically configured between Rec 709 or Rec 2100 HLG display. HLG uses linear white levels below 75% and log levels over 75%, while PQ is linear, which is why PQ has more detail. Let me illustrate what that means. The red line is the grayscale value of SDR, and it's essentially a straight line from pure black to pure white. All right, slight curve, but straight line. What hybrid log gamma does is it matches the SDR gamma curve to about 75%, then switches from linear to log, which allow it to cram more highlights into a more limited space. This is why broadcasters like it. They can fit it within their existing infrastructure. There's another setting we have to pay attention to, though, and that is up under File, go to Project Settings, under General, File, Project Settings, General. Here's what's new, right down here, HDR Graphics White. And notice it will be set to one of these three values, to 100, or 203, or 300. At the 9 o'clock, it was set to 100. Today, it's set to 203. The setting that you want to pick is the 203 75% HLG. I'll illustrate what this does in a couple of minutes. So what we've just done is we have imported a clip. We've created a sequence that has all the proper HDR settings properly set. We've also checked to make sure our project settings are correct. Remember that I said the graphics white point. Now we set that to could be 100 or 203 or 300. Here's where this becomes important. Part of the advantage to HLG is that I can take an HLG signal, send it to a standard dynamic range set, and it looks okay, or a high dynamic range set, and it takes advantage of the extra white. But that means that my graphics have to be compatible with both. The way that I make my graphics compatible with both, let me select a clip here, and we'll type Stormy Seas. Select our text, and now we're going to go to the graphics panel and click Edit, and we're going to change the font to Normand, and we're going to make it big enough that it makes a statement, right about there, center it, change our inner line spacing, and make it a little bit bigger, go to the move tool, pull it down here, a little bit too big, great, and I don't want white, we're going to make it pink, because why not? Nice stormy color. And I'm going to add a background. I'm going to add a shadow because everything needs a shadow in video. Good. Now, as I look at this, okay. But why is this important? Let me illustrate. If I go up to Preferences General, notice this option right here, Display Color Management, and it's off by default. You want to turn Display Color Management off when you are doing video editing, because it makes your images look better. But if you're adding graphics or text or doing any kind of effects, you want to turn Display Color Management on and click OK. And look what just happened to my pink text. Look, for the picture will look worse. Remember, we can't use the computer monitor to monitor HDR video, but my text looks bad. Why? Because it's the grayscale value of the color that I selected exceeds that 75% display white point. We need to bring that graphic down to be, notice it's at 87%. I've got to bring it down to at least 75, and I'm going to probably pull it down to about 70. There, I've decreased the luminance level below the start of that 75% curve. Watch my text when I click OK in 2, 1, woof. Now my text looks better. The display white point is the point above which you don't want any graphic values to go or text values to go or any kind of animation that you add, because the text is not created in HDR, it's created in Rec. 709. So it just means I can't use pure white. This was an excerpt of a recent Power Up webinar. For the complete version of this online training, please visit our store at larryjordan.com/store and look for Webinar 293. By the way, when you need to stretch your training dollars, membership in our video training library saves you money and time. You can access all our videos for a low monthly price of only $19.99. That's more than 1,900 movies on a wide variety of subjects. Plus, premium members can download practice media and projects. Our training covers Apple and Adobe software. We update it multiple times each month. And for more information, visit larryjordan.com/membership. And thanks.